one of the things about being an insect is that you're cold-blooded. So the body temperature is the same as the temperature of the environment. Now, outside right now, it's about -3, -4. Last week I was in Winnipeg and it was -38. So that means that insects are experiencing all of those temperatures. What I'm excited about is understanding how they can do this. They're cold-blooded, their body temperature is -38°C. Now, if I make your body temperature -38°C, you're just hamburger meat, right? Whereas insects come back, and as you know, they come back every year. So I'm really interested in how they overwinter and how they survive that. One of the things I'm most excited about at the moment is that we work on this set of insects that can survive being frozen solid. So you take your insect, you cool it down, its body water turns to ice. If you drop it, it freezes. If you hit it, it makes a loud noise against a hard object. It's completely frozen solid. Yet, when we thaw it out, it can survive. Now, as I said, if we do this with your foot, you get frostbite and we have to remove it. With insects, they survive fine. This has huge potential for all sorts of things, ranging from just storing insects that can't survive freezing, because we use beneficial insects to defend our crops against other insect pests, but also for storing biological samples or biological tissues. So for example, organs for donation, that we wouldn't have to fly them around in a hurry by helicopter if we could store them waiting for an appropriate donor. So understanding just that simple, that small part of what we do, understanding how things can survive being frozen solid, has a huge range of applications across industry, across agriculture, and also in biomedicine.